Hey everyone, today we're going to be learning about the spin tool in Blender. So I'm going to start off by pressing Shift and then A, and then under Mesh I'm going to choose Circle. Then I'm going to press Tab to go into Edit Mode, and I'll press 1 on the keyboard to go into Vertex Select Mode. And you can see what Circle has done is just added a plain circle with no faces and just vertices. Then I'll scroll down my toolbar here, and here we have a tool called the Spin Tool. This one doesn't have a hotkey as far as I'm aware, so I usually just use it in the toolbar. You'll see straight away that a big curved tool here has appeared, and this is going to allow us to actually perform the spin operation. You also notice at the top here we have an X, Y, and Z option, and this allows us to determine how we're going to use the spin tool. Let's say I want to make my circle spin around to the right here. For that, I would need to choose a different axis, so I'm going to choose the Y axis. And that's going to allow me to spin it in this direction. Notice how when I left click and hold, we're now spinning it this way. But the problem is it's kind of stuck in the center here, and it's not kind of creating a round curved tube like I'm wanting. So I'm going to press Ctrl Z to undo that. And the most important thing to understand about the spin tool is it's determined by this 3D cursor. So as you know, you can move your 3D cursor using the Shift S menu, which allows you to move your cursor to either things you have selected or back to the center of the world. And you can also move it manually by pressing Shift right click. And you can see as I've moved my cursor there, the spin tool has changed. And now if I was to left click and hold it, you can see it's going to be spinning it around that point that I've created. I'll press Ctrl Z to undo that. And something you'll notice is if you try to press Ctrl Z to return your cursor to the center, it won't work. Instead, to return your cursor to the center, you have to press Shift and then S, and then choose Cursor to World Origin. Another thing we can do is we can move the geometry itself instead of the 3D cursor. So I can press A to select my entire circle, and then G and then X, for example, and then I'll just move my circle along. And now we have our cursor in the center, and we have our circle to the left here. Now I can left click and hold my spin tool here, and as I left click and drag, it's just going to spin around the center like that, which works nicely for us. Once you've completed your spin operation, you can open this spin menu here to make some adjustments to your settings. For example, I could change my steps, so if I turn this down, you're going to notice it's going to create less geometry in between our spin. And obviously if I increase this to maybe something like 32, you can see we now have a nice smooth looking donut. Angle is just how far the spin went, so as you might imagine, if I change this to 360, it's going to overlap back with the original circle, which could be good if you want to create a complete donut like this. You'll also notice there's this auto merge tool here, and that means when the vertices are overlapping, they will be joined together, which is really handy. Flip normals, if you're familiar with what normals are in Blender, it's going to change the direction of the normals of these faces. The reason why this tool is here in the first place is because if I come up to my overlays option and in the drop down I turn on face orientation, you can see for whatever reason when I've done the spin tool on this circle, the normals have become the wrong way around, which can sometimes happen. So the Blender developers added this flip normals option, so when this happens you can easily just turn it back on, and that will save you having to go and correct the normals later. You can see we can also adjust the center, which is that where the 3D cursor is, and the axis after we've finished editing as well. The last tool we have is use duplicates, and if I turn this on, you're going to see nothing is going to be connected now, as it's just going to duplicate our entire object. I'll press Tab to come back into object mode, and I'll press G and X to move my object along, and I'm going to press Shift A, and then under Mesh, I'm going to choose Cylinder. If you want to turn off this normal direction, you can come up to your overlays and then turn off the face orientation. Just make sure to check it whenever you change something. Then I'll press Tab to come into Edit Mode, and I'm going to press G and X to move my cylinder along. And this time, I'm going to choose the Z axis because I want to make a bunch of duplicated cylinders going around in a circle. So I'm just going to left click and drag the tool. And you can see by default, since I had the entire cylinder selected, it's created a bit of a mess for us. But if I change this to use duplicates, and then I maybe change the number to something a bit lower, like 12, maybe even lower than that, maybe let's go for 8, you can see I've got a bunch of cylinders going in a circle. And I can change it to 360, now we've got a perfect circle of cylinders. So that's the usefulness of the use duplicates tool. I'll press Tab to come back into object mode, and yeah, that pretty much covers the basics of how to use the spin tool in Blender. As you can imagine, it can be quite useful for quite a few cases, as long as you understand that it's based around this 3D cursor. If you want to learn more about the 3D cursor, I highly recommend checking out this video here. And if you want to learn more Blender modeling tips like this, make sure to check out this playlist with a bunch of tips for 3D modeling, such as the tools like this one, and also some good fundamentals you need to learn modeling in Blender. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.